Hello all, it's Dan here again, and what I got for you is the type of video I haven't made in a bit, and I need to get back to because it was the backbone, the type of video that's the backbone of this YouTube channel. Yes, it's time for another backpack-focused video. I hope you're excited about this as much as I am, because I can't wait to talk about today's topic, which is backpack duffels. Yeah, things like these babies here. And the main theme that I'm going to discuss is why I think you should consider buying a backpack duffel. Because at the end of the day, these things are pretty useful for a variety of applications, a variety of purposes. And I really like to have at least a couple in my arsenal of backpacks to get the job done. As I mentioned, this is probably going to be more of an informative video rather than a review video, because first of all, these backpacks here are actually discontinued models. This is a Granite Gear packable duffel, and I'm not sure that they even offer this one anymore. It's not on their website. And this is a Mr. Rand's Mission Duffel, and this is the first generation of the Mission Duffel. They have since come out with a new one, which is pretty nice in itself. So, you know, I'd recommend looking at that one if you're interested. I will cover some of the features of these packs and what I like about backpack duffels in general, but the main focus of this video is just going to be talking about backpack duffels for people that might be looking at them and are maybe on the fence about getting one. Well, spoiler alert, I think you should get one, and let's get to that information right now. It's time for the most important question of this video, and that is, what are the advantages of a backpack duffel compared to something that is just like a straight duffel or some sort of dedicated travel pack that's got a little more features but also has backpack carry? Well, I've got five main principles lined up about that, and they are simplicity, durability, versatility, affordability, and accessibility. Okay? And all those things, all those liddies, that's a lot of liddies, are things that I like about backpack duffels that other types of backpacks or just duffels don't offer. Now, first of all, the most obvious feature is the versatility. There's different ways you can carry this. I mean, you've got your traditional handle carry. You can do the shoulder strap carry, or you can utilize these backpack straps. That's probably the best part of these things. I mean, it's just the ability when you're walking along, maybe you've got a long walk to from the parking lot to your office or the gym, or you're in an airport, or you're wandering around some city trying to get to your hotel, and you can just throw these straps on and carry this backpack, this duffel, like it's a backpack. And that versatility is a great feature of these types of packs. Now, some of these packs are a little fancier than the others. This Granite Gear duffel is about as simple as it gets for a duffel backpack. It's just like a big opening, you know, and then it's got one little pocket that's water resistant with this fleece lining, and the straps are built into the main carry handles. And that's actually pretty convenient because you don't have to take them out of a pouch like this. You can just throw it on and use it as the backpack. And then you have the shoulder strap as well. But I'll be honest about these backpack duffels is that I don't really use the shoulder strap that much. I prefer to just carry it like this for a short distance, or you can use these main handles, throw it on your shoulder, or if I'm going a little bit longer, I will use the backpack straps. Even this one with this nice aftermarket Tom Bean shoulder strap, I still find the regular handle carry or the shoulder carry with both shoulders or one shoulder to be more comfortable and more convenient. But you do have that option to carry it with the shoulder strap, or you can use two backpack straps, or just carry it with the regular handles. Now, like I said, some are fancier than others. This is about as simple as it gets. And then this one over here is a little bit more complex. It's got fancier backpack straps, but the nice feature, like some of those travel packs you might have seen, is you can take these straps and you can tuck it in. And it's got a little bit more higher end of the materials and the pocketing. I mean, it's got these expandable pockets here in the front. and on the back or the bottom. This one is also expandable here, and it goes into the pack, and or you can fully fill the main compartment and just put little small items over here. And then on the inside, this mission duffel has some pockets. You got pockets on the lid, on the side there's pockets. And in terms of the materials, this is a nice like 1,000 denier, very denim-like material. The mission duffel has other materials as well that are pretty durable. And then on the inside, there's sort of this waterproof, water-resistant coating, shiny on the inside there. And this one also is water-resistant. This is pretty durable in itself, this granite gear duffel. It has like a 600 denier, I think, nylon or polyester with a water-resistant TPU coating. So that's a nice feature to have as well. And the durability, as I mentioned, is another feature I like. These are pretty durable, and so they can take a lot of wear and tear. Now, another thing I like is the versatility. You can use these for a lot of different purposes, traveling, going to the gym, everyday carry if you have a lot of stuff on a particular day, going over to a friend's house, whatever. There's a lot of different things you can do with this. And the other price point, the other point that I like is the price point, the affordability. Because compared to your average travel pack, these tend to be a little bit cheaper than something that's a real fancy dedicated travel pack with all kinds of pockets and organization and laptop sleeves and features like that. So it just hits a lot of these marks in terms of simplicity, durability, affordability, versatility, and accessibility. It's really easy to get stuff in and out of it because it's got nice big pockets. It doesn't have too many pockets. It's hard to forget where you're gonna put stuff. And so all those liddies are features that I really like in backpack duffels that make them, in my opinion, a little bit more usable than a regular duffel, while also a bit simpler, more affordable than a dedicated travel pack. Of course, it's not all sunshine and roses with backpack duffels, because there definitely are a few disadvantages. And one of them is there really is a little bit of lack of organization, a lack of pocketing, pouches, sleeves, organizer panels, all that kind of stuff. They're a little light on those because at the heart, they are duffels. So if you get, you know, a dedicated everyday carry pack, a dedicated carry-on travel pack, you're going to have a little bit more feature-wise. However, I have discovered there are ways around that because I like to use these packs for one-bag travel if you're a one-bag traveler. This one is particularly nice for that. It's a little big. Only really fits Southwest carry-on requirements officially because you ever been on an airplane and see the kind of giant bags people bring? Yeah, nobody's checking on the carry-on requirements. So this Mystery Ranch fits the Southwest carry-on requirements. This thing right here, if you just compact it down a little bit, it's going to fit most airline carry-on requirements. The way I stay organized is all kinds of pouches and packing cubes, and I actually have even laptop sleeves. I mean, you could bring like a DOP kit or a little tech pouch or just a little pouch for small items. I mean, you can bring packing cubes. You can bring like this little toiletry kit here. And actually, this is kind of a funny story here. This is actually the stuff sack that you're supposed to pack this into, which is why it's called a packable duffel. Well, this is a pretty thick, durable fabric. It's kind of hard to fold it down into this little pouch. You can do it, but it's a lot of work. And I kind of just don't do that. I just kind of use this as a toiletry bag and stuff it inside. Or as you can also kind of use this and attach it to the outside if you really want to do that, which I don't really do because I try to fit everything into one bag travel, right? So, you know, you can have all kinds of pouches and organizer kits and tech kits and all that kind of stuff. And all these, you know, different things to keep yourself organized for one bag travel. Or just get a little higher end one that has a few extra pockets in it compared to your more simple packable duffel. The other thing that might be a deal breaker for a lot of people is the lack of a laptop sleeve. I got good news for you. There's ways around that. You can get yourself like a waterproof padded laptop sleeve. And this is just sort of like an AquaQuest laptop sleeve I got off Amazon. It's got a padded sleeve. It's water resistant. It's got taped seams and all that stuff. So this will do the job if you need a laptop sleeve. You can kind of place it on top if you want easy access to it, or you could stuff into the bottom of the pack. Anyways, the whole point of that is that even though there isn't a dedicated protective laptop sleeve, you can get yourself a pretty protective laptop sleeve in the aftermarket and put it wherever you like in your backpack duffel for easy access. So in my opinion, that's one of the easy ways around the lack of organization and the lack of pocketing. Another thing that might not be ideal with these is the sort of carry and comfort. And so this one, this simple Granite Gear duffel, it's pretty simple. It's got no structure, it's got no frame, no padding. And so it's okay if you just pack it with clothes and all that stuff. I mean, I get by okay with this thing. I just put some clothes in this and it fits me pretty well. And it's comfortable enough. If it's heavy with all kinds of electronics or whatever, that can get a little annoying. This one actually has a frame sheet. As I showed you before, these backpack straps, I mean, they're real thick and comfortable. This thing is nice to carry for a longer distance. So if you do want a more comfortable backpack duffel, you should look at ones that have that mention in the specifications that it has a sort of frame, some sort of hard plastic frame sheet. It has some structure to it. And that really helps overcome any concerns with carry and comfort. Another factor which might be unappealing is these packable duffels, they can get kind of expensive. You know, this one runs for over $100. I got this on sale for like 70 or whatever. This one I got for 20. But compared to just your standard old duffel bag, they are kind of expensive. However, compared to your higher-end dedicated travel pack, they do represent a deal. And they do kind of, in my opinion, they do two different purposes at once. That's one of the versatility things I like about this that allows me to not spend as much on multiple bags. I have a bag that can do two or three different jobs. So that's just a few things, a few cons that I kind of wanted to dispel a little bit. And maybe you'll consider those in whatever you want to buy in the future. Let's circle back around to one of the main points of this video. And should you consider getting one of these to add to your own personal backpack collection? And honestly, yeah, I think it's a good consideration. It's nice to have one or two of these laying around for whatever. Now, there are different types of backpack duffels you can get. You can go simple, like this packable duffel, or you can go more complex if you want something with a few more features. So there's different routes you can go with these. And the price point is great depending on what purpose you're going to use it for. So at the end of the day, yeah, I'd recommend getting one of these because you can use it for going to the gym, going to a friend's house, traveling, or just everyday carry when you need to carry a lot of stuff. I think that's about enough in this video about backpack duffels. That's probably entirely too detailed and too much information about this type of backpack. But I just wanted to put some information about there about why I think people should that are interested in backpacks should consider owning a backpack duffels and maybe convince some of you that are on the fence about it. So thanks for tuning in, folks. Appreciate your viewership and all that. You can like, subscribe, and tell me if I look good in orange, if I don't look good in orange. I don't know. Do whatever you want, folks. Have a nice day and enjoy all your backpacks. See you later.